Jacob is probably one of the biggest, most athletic guys that I've had the opportunity to coach. And Jacob has both size. He has great lateral quickness. He's a guy with his size who can play on all three downs. So we're going to project him as a nose guard right now, but he gives us the flexibility to play a four technique as well as a three technique in passing situations.
From Southern California, broadcasting around the world.
Around the world.
You're listening to the Mic'd Up Podcast. We talk, you listen. But the real question is, are you ready to get mic'd up?
Let's fire up, ladies and gentlemen. It is game day and the Trojans are up 17-0. Who would have thought? We got a big legend today, Jacob Daniel, an ex-USC football player. Good friend of mine, and let's just get drinking, right? It's game day. We got to get the mimosas going. Hold on. Everybody's pretty antsy about putting on the headphones, but please, Jacob, get mic'd up.
Let's do it, baby.
Headphones on, and let's get the mimosas cracked right now.
Let's go.
So I'll crack mine open, and we got a big day for you guys. We'll be doing a mimosa challenge. We're going to try to get as much of this as we can and maybe get some margs dabbled in as well. Oh, wow. Here, that's mine. And then open that one up. And wow, the Trojans had a good catch. So we got the game going on live. We're watching right in front of you. So it's a live reaction here on game day. And just stay tuned. We're going to have a little score counter too. That one's open too.
Oh,
and,
shit.
Let's just go. Oh, man. Another squirter on the first 30 seconds here and mic'd up. But let's pour us up a drink.
Yeah, that's why we can't have mimosa. Nice things.
And I think we just get right into it. So, Jacob, you put on the USC football team. We got a USC penalty. What the fuck's going on?
Penalties, man.
Do you want to give a little background about you? You know, where you grew up? You know, just give the viewers a little intro. You're got some.
Dude, that was awful. Champagne for you. Yeah. You know, from Fresno, California, originally. You know, did not like football at all. I was actually, you know, more of a basketball guy to start off. Didn't grow. So, you know, everybody was like, dude, you need to play football. Actually happened. Sophomore year, played. You know, we had a really good team up at Clovis North. Went to state playoffs.
Did we
played
make
Pauly. Did we make it?
We did.
There we go. Extra point.
We're a little delayed. We're a little.
Yeah.
Sorry,
nah, no worries. Yeah, so.
20-0.
20-0. That's awesome, man. That makes me feel a lot better.
I think I may be paying for the Duffy today with my winnings.
Dude, right on.
So stay tuned. We got a – sorry to interrupt. I'm not going to interrupt you anymore, but we got a Duffy going in like an hour. So this is a hard stop at like an hour, hour and a five. So yeah. We got a drink. We got to get all the stories out. We have a lot to talk about, but I'll let you finish.
Yeah. So, yeah, again, Fresno, California, Clovis North High School. We had a pretty good team, and, you know, I was not expecting to keep on playing football or get an offer. I thought I'd been a Fresno State guy. Next thing you know, I think it was around, like, April, my sophomore year, schools from all over the country started coming at me. It was pretty overwhelming at first. You know, it's a bunch of coaches coming to school every day, getting pulled out of class. It was crazy, man.
I think right now
it's still hard to fathom.
We'll flash the Sark bite. I think that's legend. So flash the Sark bite, the analysis of you, which we can read off. Coach Sark, who we are going to get into, he wrote, and we're flashing this right now on the screen, Jacob Daniel is a big physical defensive lineman, 325 pounds, but has the athleticism for that size. We think he's a guy who can come in and have an immediate impact with us. Four-star, eighth-ranked defensive lineman in the nation.
Yeah.
And 6'4", 325.
I was probably like 350
my senior year, dude. 350, but they took that number down a little bit.
Dude, I was coming off of ACL. A lot of people don't know this. Beginning of my senior year, I was 370. I came off of ACL, and like, you know, when you're in high school, they don't teach you how to rehab correctly. So like, what was I doing? I was just lifting upper body and eating a bunch of pizza. Yeah,
oh, man.
Dude, let's get these mimosas.
I think we fill this one up and chug it all. I mean, if you can handle it.
Little orange.
I can handle it
because.
I need some orange juice as well. But Trojans up 20-0. We got a lot to talk about. We're only getting started. I mean, I think we – I have a lot of football player friends, but I want to hear as much as I can about the Sark era, Helton, all the recruits, the culture, your current analysis of the program and everything. So let's just chug these real quick, and then we'll get right into it.
Chug.
I'm going to chug it all, yeah.
Fuck let's
it.
Go.
I think you need to put some more in there. Come on. We're coming off Connor Fugman, who you know, great friend of yours. I actually met Jacob through Connor. He's like, my buddy is coming in, sophomore year from Clovis North. Let's fucking put these down. Before, I think we cheers to the Post in Villa Park.
Yeah,
one of my favorite bars. Shout out Billy Scuffington and Will for having us here. It's one of my favorite bars. Some might call it a cougar den, but we love that. And I'm just making the obvious statement. It is kind of a cougar den, but I enjoy it. Shout out Nolan Halal. He's not getting away from that. Nolan Halal, shout out. He knows what I'm talking about. So, shout out the Post.
Yeah, shout out to the Post. Thank you guys for giving us the room. Thanks for having us.
What a beautiful setup. I hope to be back. Cheers.
Let's go.
Fight on. Wow. Gee, we're getting messy a couple minutes in.
Towel.
We got the Trojan Cup going here. All right. We're going to get back on track. So, Fresno, Clovis North, you want to go to Washington.
Yeah.
Can you give the viewers a rundown on that? So, Sark, who was a coach of, I think right now, I think we just have to flash the Sark rally.
Oh, God.
So,
yeah.
we'll take a minute. I'm going to edit this in. We're going to flash at the pep rally. Sark saying, fight the fuck on, motherfuckers, right? So, yeah. 1, 2, 3, we'll flash that for you guys.
Get ready to ride on, baby. Let's go.
I mean, I'll let you comment on. I will let you comment on what they just saw. You were there, right?
Yeah.
The guy that recruited you to Washington.
Yeah. So I'll start off with just saying I wanted to play for Sark. You know, I had spent a few days up, summer going in my junior year at Washington. Saw the campus. Really fell in love with Seattle and, like, you know, love Sark, love Justin Wilcox and all that staff. And I was just like, you know, let's go here. Partially because I tore my ACL at the end of my junior season. I tried to keep it on the low. Didn't think I was going to get, you know, have any more strong interest from schools because of that. So it was also because of that. But, man, it's great up there. You know, hopefully I can live in Seattle for a few years down the line.
So if Sark stayed at Washington, you would have went there?
Oh, yeah.
100%.
I would have been a dog.
You would have been a dog?
Yeah.
And I don't even know. I'm pouring you. I think we're going to kill these, bro.
Yeah,
I'm
serious. We're done.
We're almost done. Oh, my gosh. Whew. I mean, this is Rivals, like, the lucky episode where we were done with like, the UV almost in, like, 20 minutes.
I mean, dude, UV goes down, like, it's pretty much
we
candy,
love UV.
Dude. So, it's a Jolly Rancher to me.
I agree. So, Washington, but your mom wanted you to go to Stanford.
Yeah, so let me tell you a story about that. So, like, obviously, you know, once Sark left, I did not want to go to USC, dude. I just did not. And it was, you know, it became the point of, like, okay, you need to go somewhere where you actually want to go. You don't want to just go for the coaches. Oh, we fumbled. Damn. But, yeah, it wasn't about the coaches. I wanted to really make a decision that would have, you know, benefited me in life. So, yeah, my mom wanted me to go to Stanford. What caused me not to do that was they wanted me to take the SAT 5 more times. Even though my score was good, they just wanted guys that wanted to be competitive. They also said you need to take 2 AP classes your senior year. So that was a no-go. And it's just boring up there, man.
I actually visited up there on a official recruiting trip with my buddy Louis Vecchio.
So, really? You went with Louis?
So I got, like, he brought me. It was Louis and Lance Vecchio will be right here soon. They're coming on, the two brothers, in 2 or 3 episodes. They'll be on here right here. But I went up there with Louis, his dad, his uncle, and me.
Do you meet David Shaw?
We were, yeah, I mean, I got the VIP, like, it was Lewis, uncle, dad, and me.
Dude, how boring is that place?
Notre Dame, Stanford, VIP. We drove up, all the way up, and all the way back one day.
God damn.
One day, all the way up,
all the
way
back. Southern California, all the way up there?
Yeah. And
Jesus.
They wanted Lewis to run. I'm trying to learn more about football, but I bet on it almost every day I can. Geez. So, can you explain to me the why? What is the why?
Yeah, it's a tight end position.
It's 2 dual
tight ends? He's perfect size for that.
Is the why 2 tight ends?
No, the why is just 1 tight end.
So, Stanford runs 2 tight ends, right?
Yeah.
So, they wanted Lewis to run dual tight ends with Dalton Schultz, who's currently on the Cowboys.
Really? That was his recruiting class?
They wanted Lewis and Dalton to run together.
Damn. Would have been nice. Lewis is a big guy.
But I think but Holden, who's in the crowd here, went to UPenn with him. It's hard to turn down a Wharton degree.
Yeah, you can't turn that down at all.
As you know. Anyway, we'll wrap it up. So, at the end of the day, you picked USC. Obviously, any regrets there?
No, not at all, man. It was, you know, I'm originally from Carson, California. I grew up there. So, like, I grew up watching USC, like, my whole life. It was just the best decision socially, academically,
folks,
and football-wise.
We partied. Yeah. We partied. Yeah. I'll tell you that. Yeah, don't worry about that.
That definitely factored my decision.
We partied more than anybody at Stanford ever could.
Yeah, well, I mean, Stanford.
Give me Stanford's number one fucking partier nerd, 36 ACT. Dude. He ain't got us one bit.
No, and it's just dry over there, man.
It's how Much about respect. The women? How are the women up there in Stanford?
I wouldn't say
the best.
I did not see one girl
that you like
when I went up there. No,
you saw zero.
Nah, there's probably a volleyball player though. They had to sit in like this dude, they had to sit in like a psychology class for like 3 hours. Yeah, the whole fucking lecture.
All right, drinks go. Down the hatch. Let's hear about the volleyball players.
Yeah, man. I just remember there's one volleyball girl in that class. She was like 6'2". She was fine. That was about it. Dude, that was like 7 years ago.
But then you come to SC and you got the number one volleyball team in the nation.
Yeah.
The girls, I've been getting a lot of like, last episode, Connor's like, when you talk about women, it sounds like cougars. I'm going to call them girls.
All right. Works for me.
A lot of hot girls at SC.
Yeah, it's insane. And I think it like thwarts our perception, like from real life to that. SC's not real life.
No, it's not. It just isn't.
It's not at all.
All right, we got a lot to talk about here. So, real quick, one sentence, how was playing for Coach Sark at USC? If you can sum it up in one sentence. You got one sentence.
One sentence, huh? Awesome. That's awesome. It. Yeah. I honestly, I thought that, you know, he had a good program going. We had a good offense. Everything was fine. I thought that, you know, with the strength staff and, you know, just how everything was organized. But, you know, as we just pulled up that rally video, he was going through some stuff at that point in life.
And, I do feel bad for him, but from what I heard from all my buddies on the team was like, what, he came in one Sunday and was like ragging on somebody in the locker room saying, you're fucking hungover, you fucking partied, and then he's fucking blitzed himself. Is that true?
I was not there for that. It was probably the year before I came in. But yeah, it just, you know, you go through stuff in life.
So, and you were not on the plane when he was just cracking open booze from Washington?
No, I was not there.
Were
for
you
that.
There? Even if he was, they're not going to rat him out.
Dude, you got to think, dude, as a recruiter, Sark is money, man.
Yeah.
Like, that guy could sell used cars.
Can somebody in the audience check if Texas won today?
Did they win?
Because I had a little parlay. Shout out Joe Ferguson in Wisconsin. They fucked me. So.
How much did you win on Iowa last night?
300. 350.
It's not bad, man. 32-27
with 4 minutes left.
That's and guess what Vegas had that at? -4.5. They're on the dot. I mean, it's crazy, right? I didn't even have to ask. So stay tuned on that. But Colorado's about to score. I was worried to schedule this podcast at this time because I don't know if anybody knew, but USC's never, ever, ever in our history lost to Colorado. Ever. Did you know that?
Ever?
Ever.
Damn.
And it doesn't look like we are still.
I mean, they just scored. We'll see, man.
All right. We'll keep going. So, I think we got to – okay. Real quick. In your recruiting class, you had Sam Darnold, Porter Gustin, Amon Marshall, Ricky Town, Marvell Tell. Can you give people a little rundown on those guys? And, like, obviously we saw you ranked number 8 in the country. I mean, I don't – that's pretty legendary. Just a rundown of how it was being in the locker room.
I mean, yeah. I mean, we had a badass recruiting class. I mean, you know.
You're a Pac-12 champion.
Yeah, Pac-12.
You're a Rose Bowl champion.
Rose Bowl, all that. Yeah. But I'm just saying, like, just with those guys, I mean, they worked super hard. They were, you know, blue chip guys coming out of high school. I mean, yeah. Marvell Tell was really good out of Crespi. Sam Darnold, hey, I'll say this. I called that. I knew it.
You knew it?
Like, when I first met the guy at the Army game, I hadn't met him because everybody was like, who the hell is this Darnold kid?
I have in my notes here about the Alabama SC game, which you were there. Obviously, on the field.
Yeah.
I want to flash the photo, I'm not going to pause this, of Connor Fugman and I, who you just saw in the last episode, in the stands. We went to Hooters. Sorry. We went to a Nico Sway concert in downtown Dallas. Shout out Nico Sway. Flash that concert right now. We went from there to meet his dad at Hooters up the road from AT&T.
Really?
Got some Hooter wings with Brett Fugman, and then we went to the game. And I was pumped up. Max Brown was a quarterback.
Yeah.
I do like Max Brown. That's your frat brother?
Yeah, I love Max Brown.
Great guy.
Shout out Brownie.
Great guy, but, you know, if that game didn't happen, there would be no Sam Darnold.
I wouldn't say that.
50 is it? What did we lose by?
Dude, we got our ass whooped.
So flash the photo right now of me, man, and Connor. The game was over. We were in club level, and you'll see by our faces.
That first quarter was hyped, though.
I walked home.
You walked home after that?
From AT&T to the Airbnb, and now that I do real estate in Texas, I walked far.
Yeah, I'll say this.
I walked far. I was pretty down.
I'll say this.
It was slaughtering.
It was, but I'll tell you this. Like, before that game, we thought we were going to beat their ass, dude. Like, we worked all summer, and we thought we went there to win.
I just watched the video of you guys coming out of the tunnel. And now I agree with you. And we'll flash that real quick. Flash it in the background.
No nonsense, but this was a little exciting here. Kind of crawling and slowly making their way to the field.
They look like they're ready. That kind of represents America when it comes to the college football season, how excited everybody is to see college football back this weekend.
It looked like you guys were going to win by 50.
Oh, bro, we were about to eat that.
What happened? What happened right here on the Mic'd Up podcast? What happened? Be honest with the viewers.
It's fucking Bama, dude.
I know.
Like, what do you expect? Like, first and foremost, like, we played them in AT&T Stadium, and it's just Bama. We weren't ready as a team. That's just it. They just beat us, dude.
I think
they would have clipped Blake Barnett in, because I think that's who we game planned for, we probably would have been a closer game.
He went to Capitol Valley High School, right?
No. Somewhere, he's from the IE. Corona, he's a Corona guy.
Got it. All right. We're going to keep it moving. Favorite quarterback that you've ever been on a team with, and you can take in all the different attributes. Who's your favorite? Is it Sam Darnold?
Yeah, of course it's Sam.
Go Panthers. Real quick, you were there for the JT Slovis situation. By the way, JT Daniels, a big sender. I just saw a video on TikTok of him at the Georgia bar, which I was trying to download it on TikTok. He was wearing a hoodie in Georgia after he won last weekend. He went to the bar with a hoodie.
Yeah, no, that's what he does, man.
He's a partier. He's a gamer. I actually like him, and I didn't meet him a couple times at my legendary 4th July party, which were you there?
Oh, dude.
You were there, right?
I don't even want to think about that right now. That was
a lot of people in the crowd were there, too.
If I think about that, I'm going to get hungover.
I mean, it was – you. If you've seen the other episodes, you know that was just crazy.
I'll say this about JT, though. He is a savant, man. You know, the guy doesn't do his hair. He wears pajamas all the time, but he comes to work. I really had a lot of respect for him during his time at USC. I mean, you know, he came in. The kid hadn't even gone to prom yet, and he was starting, you know, his first year.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, when Keaton came in, he, you know, knew the offense, and he was able to flourish.
I think it's a halftime chug. It's halftime now. Turn up the music real quick. Sorry to interrupt you. Let's do a little – let's pour it up. We got another song going. And let's send this back real quick. I'll actually let you pick the song. Any song you want. What's your favorite song?
Favorite song.
Right now, what do you want to drink to? Just we got the iPad here.
Let's do way,
the post.
Let's just do Way Too Sexy. I got a fresh haircut for it.
Okay. YouTube has been on my ass about taking fucking copyright shit, but hopefully they'll be good. All right. Way Too Sexy. Oh, it's two. I put two in there, the correct two. All right, ready. When this goes, pour up. We got some bikers out front. I don't know if you got this microphone. Ready?
Let's finish the bottle.
Oh, fuck. Yeah. I'm going to turn it all the way up because I don't give a fuck.
Let's get some orange juice, man.
Trojans up 20-7. 6-7. 20-6 or 7? 20-7, fight on. Dante Williams. He shouldn't have lost last week, right? Or what?
That was embarrassing.
Does he have a chance or no? Still.
No. Or is he done? I don't think so. I don't think he's done. I think he's done, dude.
He's
it's
done.
Like,
Mic'd Up Podcast, August 2nd. Dante Williams is a dead in the water, but we like him. Pour it up. Twenty to seven, cheers. Okay, put it back. That's fine. Ooh. Okay. Think we got too sexy for that metro housing. Diamond popped out, almost swallowed 60,000 pieces. I want a Stanford guy to chug that right now. They can't.
No, they can't.
They can't do that. Alright. We'll turn it a bit down. Alright. Anyway, real quick. Best player you ever saw. This was a question written in by a fan. Best player you've ever played with at your time at USC?
Elijah Vera Tucker, hands down.
Is he on an NFL team right now?
Yeah, he got drafted, I think, 14th overall to the Jets this year. You know, guy was my lifting partner.
Off.
Guy was unreal. Perfect technique, everything, this approach to the game, everything good, and he's just a good kid.
Okay. Any comment? So that was it. The viewers, actually, this is sent in from Brendan Garfinkel, my frat brother. He wanted you real quick. You were there during the JT Slovis competition.
Yeah.
And one of my good buddies and viewers wanted to know, did you actually believe that Slovis won the job or no?
So it wasn't really the situation of who won the job. It was, you know, JT obviously got hurt the first half of the Fresno State game at the beginning of the season.
I had $1,000 on it, me and Connor.
Oh, yeah, dude, you were sad after that. I remember that.
So I lost a lot of bets, a lot of them on injuries. Right?
Yeah.
So if that ACL didn't go down, I'd probably win.
Probably.
So I lost on ACL.
But, you know, it was just one of those situations where Keaton, you know, we threw him in the Stanford game, and he just flourished, you know?
Yeah.
And it got to the point where, you know, he was our quarterback. It was his team. And that was just it. JT is a fantastic player, and he's going to be really successful still. I mean, the guy's too smart. He has too much arm talent
so
not to be.
You're getting to where I am. They want to know, who do you think is going to be more successful in the NFL? And I believe JT.
Yeah, I would say JT as well.
And let me lay out my viewpoints as just a fucking guy who bets.
Yeah, I want to hear what you got to say.
So if you look at the best quarterbacks in USC history, Matt Leinart, partier.
Yeah.
He had a good time. He lived in the moment. He could handle USC. Sam Darnold, I bought him many AMFs at the 9-0 after wins.
Oh, fuck.
He's a partier and a gamer. Okay?
Yeah.
JT Daniels, again, ton of White Claws. He's a partier and a gamer. And you got Slovis. I don't think he's it. And we'll leave it at that.
I think Slovis is going to be successful in the NFL. I think they're both NFL quarterbacks, to be fully honest with you.
All right. The audience is going real quick. They're saying we gotta you know, keep it going.
Yeah, let's keep it going.
So real quick, playing for Helton.
Yeah, I think that I'll be completely frank with this.
We'll be quick with this, yeah.
Yeah, you know, at the time that he got the job, it was, you know, the perfect situation. Oh, is that BLT?
Can you come on the camera to say what's up?
Yeah.
What's your name, brother?
Rafael.
Rafael, come on here. Come on here real quick. Sorry, don't trip. USC. Rafael, thank you, brother.
You're welcome.
Get on the show. Thank you, brother.
Thank you. Thank
Rafael's you. My middle name, by the way.
We got a BLT coming in hot. Let's go. Yeah. Fight on. Little fight on. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank
you. Let's go. Legend. All right, real quick. Playing for Helton versus... How was playing for Helton? One sentence or two?
Thing I can say about that. I'm gonna have to expand on this.
Okay.
Because it was pretty complex. You know, we chose him to be our coach.
Yeah.
You know, that after, you know, 2015, after the whole Coach Sark situation, I thought he was the perfect man for the job. You know, he really cared about his players.
Oh my gosh, hold on.
Yeah, we finished those, dude. We deleted them.
I mean, these are done, folks.
It's a blank Word doc.
These have been done. These are done. My mom's out of here. Great viewer. You want to come on camera? You probably do. So, come on. Come on camera. Come on camera. She's scared of the camera, I guess.
Mike, go to the fucking good stories.
Yeah.
Hold on. No, we're good.
You can cut it out.
No, this is no. It's good. My mom's on camera here. We're not cutting this. She's been dying to see an episode. Love her. There you go. There we go. Out. Now they gotta leave. Now the real stories start, right? Now when they leave,
get into it.
The real stories start. Okay, out. Boat. Dad and mom out. Okay, out. Halftime. Quick. And then we gotta. And then when they leave, we're gonna turn this bitch up. We're gonna turn this motherfucker up to a different level.
Yeah.
We got 30 minutes. The football. People are saying like cut the football talk, but I'm interested in it.
Yeah, no.
So real quick,
talking.
And the viewers are so. Real quick, Helton, that guy's lost me so much motherfucking money. It's not even funny.
Well,
he never. Yeah. By the way, out of 136 football teams, he is 132nd of covering the spread in his tenure. Did you know that?
No.
He's the worst of covering.
I mean, cover
the spread. Nick Saban always does.
Does he really?
So real quick, we have two more minutes on the USC, and then we're gonna get the Margs ordered. I think we gotta make a. We love the post. I think we got to order some Margs, right?
Yeah, let's do it, man.
But as I do that, you have 2 minutes. What is your opinion on Helton being fired? 1, 2. Who do you believe should be picked to run the USC football program?
Okay, so
order the margaritas, I want your true commentary. That's it.
Yeah. So let me start on Clay Helton. First and foremost,
by the way, you have 2 minutes.
All right. First and foremost, he came in at a time where, you know, there was kids that were older, you know, that came in before I was. They had Kiffin, they had the Cocho situation happen, and then, you know, again, like Sark came in. They didn't really want Sark, I don't think. They didn't really vibe well with him. A lot of those guys didn't like him, but like me as
and
a freshman.
Know, they didn't want Ed Ogeron because he didn't speak clearly.
Yeah, but
how sad is that?
Yeah, it's really sad. But I'll be honest, I probably wouldn't have went to SC if Coach O was the coach. I didn't really like Coach O that
much. Can you understand him?
Oh yeah, I can understand him, but like yeah. I didn't want to play for Coach O. Just being completely honest. I wouldn't have been at SC, I would have been at Washington. But you know, I came in, I love Sark. So I think for those guys, they had all this, you know, kind of mistrust with the athletic program and everything. And, you know, Helton coming in was a blanket of protection and just like stability. For the time that was there, obviously, you know, 2018, we didn't make a bowl game. We went 8-5 my fifth year. And it was, I think, you know, after that 2018 year, the writing was kind of on the wall. But I think that he, for what happened and the situation, he came in and he did a great job. But I think, you know, he'll have success.
He was a Band-Aid of the bigger situation.
He was a Band-Aid for the situation. But, I mean, I think he did a great job. And, I mean, you know, I wouldn't have stayed all 5 years if it wasn't for him. I thought he did a good job. He was really player-centric and really cared about us.
The players, is the GoPro still live? Is it still alive? Okay. We've had some GoPro issues. But a lot of people were calling him Big Horse. What does that mean? I'm fucking confused.
All right. So, like, he actually, like, used to call us, all the players, Big Horses. You know, he would come up to, you
big
know.
Big Horse. I just don't understand that.
The man's just a big horse, dude. Like, that's literally it. Like, he's the biggest.
Who's a big horse?
Clay Helton.
He's not a big. If you want to see a big horse, Dad, on the set right now. Come on the set right now. Don't trip. If you want to see a big horse, this is a big horse right here. This is his dope.
Big Dan Feehan.
Give me the Tito's here. So, Helton is not a big horse. You're a big horse, and this is a bigger horse, right? This is a bigger horse right here.
Hey, man. Nah, he would.
How much do you weigh?
285.
What do you weigh?
I am 320 right now. I lost 15 pounds.
Is he bigger than you?
Sucks, huh?
No, it's actually pretty good, man. I can dunk again, so I'm feeling good.
I can't jump.
What?
I can't jump.
No, I'm saying is like he's a double knee replacement.
Oh, shit. Yeah, I forgot you did do that.
Yeah.
I really remember the story with me involved was in Cabo.
Oh my God, that was.
Wasn't that legend?
So we got right here. Legend. All that them. This was, by the way, this was not scripted at all.
I don't know,
dude. Here.
$1,000 on that boat.
So my dad bought
that boat was
a 55 foot what here.
I don't know. It's a big sport fishing.
You gotta talk in the mic.
Oh yeah.
This is gonna happen for 2 minutes.
All right. So I chartered a boat. How many guys were on that thing?
There was a lot of us.
Oh God. We drank all the booze. We had to get more booze. We had a panga. They were on the front of the mango deck, right?
Yeah, I was right in front of the mango deck. But what I remember was I flew in. So we had come off the plane, booked the whole, got into our hotel rooms, and then we just went straight to the boat. That's what happened. And I remember, you know, me, Christian, I think my boy Cheddar was there. My other roommate, Rohan, he had went to a Mexican hospital that night, just got back. And I had to wake him up in the room. I was like, yo, let's get up. We got to go to the boat. And he was like, what fucking boat do you mean?
Yo, and we just got on the boat. Let's go to like the Panga. No, this is a big fucking boat. It was me and then Jared, and Jared's boat was right next to us. And what flag were we flying?
We have some videos too.
So we were flying. USC. We'll flash all the photos. There's a photo of you guys. Do you have that photo of you and Dan?
No, that was of Rector and Dan. So I have it on my phone somewhere, though.
We got some, that's a great picture.
We'll put
anyway,
that up.
Anyway, but hold on. One more comment. There's somebody in the crowd here who lost his iPhone in the water. Oh, yeah. My brother lost his phone in the in front of Mango Deck, and I guess it was recovered.
No, it's gone.
Somebody turned it on, you said.
No, you threw it in the ocean.
Yeah, but somebody found it and found my iPhone, came back on, I think. Anyway, thank you, Dad. I love him. Yeah. You're out of here?
Yeah, I gotta go.
Okay.
All right, here's another mark.
He gave you a fight on.
Here's another mark about Cabo. I did not make it through one successful day when I was there.
Oh. Show the camera that. That's a good one. Flash the camera that. Can they see that? Yeah. There he is. JDan and Fugue, who you guys saw in the last episode. I mean, legendary. All right, 1 minute. Okay. 1 minute. Because are you guys out of here?
Yeah, see ya.
You can stay.
Yeah, second right, comment about
one,
Cabo, though.
One comment. Wait. Cabo.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
I didn't make it out one night. Haven't been since. I got kicked out of Mandala. Like, my third night there.
Mandala.
Dude, I was in line. Because, you know, like, it takes an hour to get in line there. They don't care about security or anything. Or, like, fire hazard. So, they just pack the place.
But, well,
I'd wait in line
I don't know if I can comment on what my dad did at Mandala. Am I allowed to or no? Can I comment on that?
Sure.
So, one of my dad's customers, so this story I can say?
Quick
story. We love, the Hispanic guys are funny guys.
It's great.
Like in their culture, it's like you can cheat, right?
Yeah.
So, they're like, Dan, you gotta put this on your card. You gotta get all the bottle service on your card at Mandala. You pay for it, we'll wire you the money. Just put it on your card. We can't have anybody seeing.
Wow.
How many guys were you with?
I paid for the whole trip.
How much was it?
$20,000.
$20,000 on your card. Because they could not. And these guys are worth how much?
Millions.
Millions. And they're like, Dan, you got to shoulder this for us. For the boys. Shoulder for the boys.
Did they wire you the money?
Yeah.
Quickly, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn, that's pretty impressive.
It's like, Dan is their Mandala. Air, whatever. Bitchin' pad. Dan's got to do it.
Damn.
Yeah.
That's pretty wild, man. I got kicked out of Mandala. I've been in that place once.
All right. I think we're ready. One more comment. We got 20 minutes to wrap this up, and we got a 20 or 30 minutes. We're actually on track. People are saying we're not on track. We are on track. Comment about we finished it. We're waiting for the Margs. They're on the way.
You want to take a break?
No. What's the GoPro at? Wise? Battery wise?
20.
We're good. Okay, last thing. My best game ever. Because we love the Trojans. Do you bleed red?
Oh, yeah, of course. I bleed USC red and Fresno State Bulldogs,
baby. I bleed
cargo
and gold. I don't give a fuck. I'll square up with anybody. I'll square up with a Texas motherfucker, which I did. Which I did in the middle of a fucking... The middle of what's that street? Figueroa? Right in the middle of the street. I just squared up with this Texas pussy. He fell down. He was so scared. And right now, cue the video. This is somebody in the crowd filmed the video. But this guy from Texas was, well, this is involved with Sark now, was so scared of me and the crew, he just fell over in the middle of Figueroa. God forbid he was picked up by his Texas fuck.
Dude,
let's cue that video right now. 1, 2, 3. It's too good to do. I was doing the McGregor behind the back.
Really?
I was like, hit me. He didn't. Smart guy.
Dude,
cue
I just
it right
remember.
Now. 1, 2, 3. Cue the video.
Dude, oh my god. Oh my god. What's going on, bro? Oh my god. 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 Oh my God, they might get hit. Oh my God. Wow. Yes. Oh, dude, there's a good Porsche. Oh my, a Maserati. Oh my God. Oh my God, dude, it's Conor McGregor, bro. Oh my God, bro. Oh my God, dude. Oh my God. Look at him, dude. It's Conor McGregor. Oh my God. Oh my God.
JDan, how was that video?
Shit, man.
He was scared, right?
Yeah, the guy was fucking pissed.
All right, one thing. After the Rose Bowl, he was scared, I'll tell you that. Scared is an understatement.
The thing is about me, if I'm ever in that situation, I'm letting my nuts hang.
What?
I'm letting my nuts hang.
Letting your nuts hang.
Yes.
Right, let's go. Let's go. Bring it in here.
My fucking God.
Chris, come on set to the left. Come around the camera. JDan, last comment. One or two sentences about the old mansion after party after we won the Rose Bowl. Chris, get on here. Sit down. Sit down. You have 1 second, Chris. Or JDan.
That was a hell of a party.
Were you there?
Oh, my God, yeah. That was crazy.
Any comments about that?
Can't say it on camera.
Okay.
Yeah, can't talk about that a lot on camera. All I will say is that my fucking dad had flew in for the game, and he wanted to spend time with me, and I ended up getting caught in a conversation with him for about 2 hours. Yes, I was chasing tail, man. Of course. Dude, I was literally like, you know how like you're in a conversation with somebody and you want the conversation to stop so you can get the fuck you're going? That happened. And I ended up giving him my Rose Bowl watch just so he could leave. My dad. He has my Rose Bowl watch still to this day. But yeah, I had to get him out because I wanted to get to that party. But that was a crazy night, man. Perfect game.
But Sam, but like I said,
almost had a damn heart attack.
Hey, by the way, the football talk is done. It's been 40 minutes of it. I loved every minute. And I think the viewers will too, because I learned a lot of shit that I didn't know before. Was there a buffalo running behind us? Probably was a minute ago.
Fuck that buffalo.
I fucking hate that motherfucker. Ralphie? Fuck that motherfucker, dude.
I don't like Colorado.
It's like Ralphie number 4 or 5. Fuck that motherfucker.
New one, dude. That thing's small.
It was a bigger one.
It's a baby buffalo.
Yeah. They've never beat us. They never will. Done.
Yeah.
I've been to Boulder. The women. The chicks, unreal.
I mean, they all wish they went to USC.
All right, one comment on the old your. Say it again.
I said all those.
No,
chicks
no, no. Say for the camera. Say, if you went to Boulder, you wish you went to USC.
No, I said all the chicks at Boulder wish they went to USC.
So say that on the record. I agree with you.
All the chicks that go to Boulder wish they went to USC.
All the chicks that went to Boulder wish they went to USC, and we'll drink to that real quick.
Boulder.
I think we sip from the fucking bottle real quick.
Nah, it's unsanitary, baby. COVID. Gotta be friendly.
I'm dripping a little bit. All right, anyway, I think we got to move on. We got to shift gears. Is it still halftime? All right, I think we shift to TikToks.
Let's do it.
Are you ready?
Let's do it.
Because this is where it really gets going. We're 40 minutes in. 40 minutes in. We got 30 minutes to wrap this shit up. But the best video yet was the Lucky. You know Lucky from Simakai?
Oh, yeah. Lucky's my guy, man.
He delivered unexpectedly one of the biggest hits on the YouTube.
Did he really?
Yeah, 13,000 views and counting.
Oh, we got to beat that.
We're going to beat it today. So you brought us some YouTube videos.
Yeah, I got a few.
So I was telling JDan, I said, you bring 3 TikTok videos, I'll bring 3. Because we got to draft some of that spirit with us. I'll let you go first. Bring me your best TikTok video that we got to react to. And then we'll throw it on later. In the meantime, right here. All right, so we're reacting live. The viewers in the crowd won't see this, but I will. All right. Hold on. Ready? One. Here, we'll actually show the viewers, okay? And then we'll throw it behind us. One, two, three.
Ain't no fucking way, boy. Boy, ain't no 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 way, boy.
Hey, I'm just going to say this.
Okay.
When I lose my hair, I'm fucking doing that.
Yo.
I'm going to be a bald man pretty soon.
Yo.
It's inevitable.
Yo. That was like some LeBron shit. Like getting the fucking... Like this guy, no way. He was bowling, right?
Yeah, bro. You got a man weave. Bro, you can literally get hair glued on... You can literally get hair glued onto the top of your lineup.
Hold on. You got to tell me how the fuck, how can somebody do that?
All right, so this is what happens. If you're fucking bald, you get, like, it's pretty much a toupee, but you get it glued onto your hair.
glued on.
It's hair.
It's fake.
It's actual hair. But like, yeah, so you get it glued on, and then like the hairstylist, barber, whoever's doing it can style it. But like,
they glue on his hair.
Yeah, they glued that shit on, dude.
I never knew this. We got to drink this. Chug this, man.
Oh, my God.
I'll tell you this. We didn't go to Stanford. We didn't go to Washington. And we didn't go to Boulder. Well, the Boulder guys send. This is SC Fight On. And we're going to get back. By the way, hold on. One thing. I never asked you. What is your... If you had to pick one coach...
Oh, shit.
Oh, whoa. They're easy there, buddy.
Dude, I'm drunk now.
I know. A lot of people can't handle the Mic'd Up podcast. Saul Armunda. Love him, but it got a bit out of hand.
Hey, shout out to Saul Armunda, man. That guy is a legend.
Did he haze Sam Darnold? Maybe.
I haze Sam Darnold.
Yeah.
We had him blindfolded one night, and I had some Popeyes, and I had to shove a tender up his mouth, dude.
What'd you say?
I shoved a chicken tender up his mouth.
What do you mean shove? You fed it to him.
Yeah. I mean, I fed it to him, but I was like, eat.
And yeah, his football buddy.
He was like, bro, no. I'm like,
by the way, we love, if you're going to be a USC quarterback and you're on a sender, please go to Stanford. Okay. Last comment. Who is your pick to be the USC next coach? You can go first. I'll go second. If you were the AD, who do you pick right now to be the coach? And I'll let you go first. Are you ready for your answer? Do you know it?
Oh, yeah.
Because I know mine.
I think first and foremost, Urban Meyer. It's just obvious. The guy looks miserable.
You can't give me an unrealistic one.
I don't think it's unrealistic.
Okay.
The guy owns a house in LA.
Give me your number two.
My number two, obviously Luke Fickell from Cincinnati.
You like him.
I think it just makes the most sense. And then my dream pick, honestly, Eric Bieniemy. Coach for the offensive coordinator from the Chiefs. He's an LA guy. He's from there. He used to coach at UCLA. He knows the landscape very well. I think he'll resonate with all the high school coaches as far as recruiting goes, and he'll put together a really badass staff.
I agree. I'll keep it quick. Number one, I'm going to go with Bob Stoops.
Really?
He's on the Fox with Matt Leinart and Reggie Bush. I quite frankly think that's going to be the pick. Second, I would go Anthony Lynn. I've been hearing some rumblings on Anthony Lynn, and people are going to give me hate for this, but that's my second pick.
Fuck no.
Okay.
All right.
Anyway, we're going to change the battery, and we'll be back. We got 20 minutes, and we got some good stories coming.
Yes, sir.
But before we close, we are going to finish these.
I already took a sip. Ready? So I'll give you a two-second head start.
Okay. 2 seconds.
Give you a head start.
There's a lot of straws here. Can somebody get me a straw? It's right over here. Thank you. Ready? 2 second head start.
Yeah.
I got hit with an ice cube.
Hey, let's run for a second.
Headphones on.
Get that jean jacket. Got me loud on it. Hey, got it better, man.
Hey. Not fat. All right. Nope. Okay.
That's my favorite song, by the way.
Here we go. We got... Ready. One. Hold on.
On the editing.
I got it.
Get the computer up.
All right. Folks, we're back at it. JDan, are you fired up?
Yeah, man, I'm fired up.
We got the Trojans are up.
I'm mic'd up.
How is it being mic'd up?
Hey, man, we're out here. We're about to have a good time after this. Let's go, baby.
All right, music off. Are we back?
Yes, we are fucking back.
So I believe I'm up for a TikTok video, right?
Yeah, it's your turn.
So we got three
each. Dude, you finished the fucking... Oh, my God.
Hey, it ain't my first rodeo here. All right, here's my TikTok. I have a bunch, but I think this brings in to right where we're trying to go. And 1, 2, 3, cue the video. I'll show the guys in the audience. Let me know your thoughts on this take. Ready? One.
bunch of people asked for this one, so these are the top party schools in California. Comment what y'all think I should do next. Let's go!
Top party schools
number
in California.
Number 10, San Jose State.
Pretty beat.
Number 9, Cal Berkeley. Number 8, UCLA. Number 7, UC Santa Cruz. Number 6, UC Davis. Number 5, Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo. Number 4, San Diego State.
I don't agree with that.
Number 3, USC. Number 2, Chico State. And number 1, UC Santa Barbara.
Okay. So, what's this guy's name? His name is, I don't know, fucking know. We will put the video up, but I don't agree with his shit whatsoever. Do you agree with him?
The top four is pretty controversial. You could have it any way.
I had to play it. We'll flash the screenshot of what he said. He said his top one was UC Santa Barbara. Have you partied there?
No, I haven't partied at UCSB.
Me either. So
I've been to Novo Lounge, though. That place is poppin'. I like Novo Lounge.
So you've been to Santa Barbara?
I mean, I've been, but like I haven't like partied at UCSB.
Okay, okay. By the way, we're going to flash the guy's screenshot on the screen. Number two was Chico State. I've been there. I have been there. I've dirty. Done it. It's dirty.
Ratchet.
That number two deserves to be honestly number like 15. So get that shit off.
No, I think Chico State honestly is number one, dude. They get dirty. They're the dirtiest, I would say. And it's the most fun. I like to get dirty, bro. I like dirt on my shirt.
That is what the viewers have been waiting for right here.
Yeah,
They've been waiting 45 minutes for that comment.
Dude, I never partied at Chico. I just heard stories and like I would say they're number one.
Okay, so I have been there. Have you been there?
No, I haven't been. Tell me.
So flash a couple of photos of me there. I've been there. I've been on the grounds.
You have boots on the ground. And
I've been there. Me and Connor Fugman last episode, we made a trip there.
Did you get dirt on your shirt?
JDan, I'll be honest. If you want to do quotes,
big run.
It was. We're watching the run now, but fight on, right?
Yeah, dude.
By the way, JDan, it was a bit too dirty for me.
Too dirty for you? I feel different strokes for different folks, but like,
yeah.
You gotta respect.
But could you go out every night and maybe get with a chick? Yeah, every night.
Yeah, that's what you want.
Yeah,
it's important. If we're talking about party schools like that, that's definitely a contributing factor.
But do you believe that they should be ranked more than us?
Yes.
You think they're higher than us?
Yes.
All right, I'm gonna adjust the list. Okay, but what are we ranking on? Are we ranking on women or on the parties?
You have to do a mixture of both.
Okay.
So
right now,
give me your top three. Give me your top three.
As you would see on the screen, we have UCSB. They ain't number one. They ain't number two. They're down. So Chico State, number one, I would say San Diego State.
I was hoping you'd say that, smart man.
Yeah.
We
met some girls down there. So number one, San Diego State, and then we're number two. Put us at number two.
Personally, my top three, I go San Diego State, Chico, then us.
Jeez, a bit controversial.
Dude, everybody's bougie at USC. Nobody like really sins.
I would go San Diego State, SC. If we're talking about girls, then Chico State 3. But we're in the top three.
Oh, we're top three by far.
As we talked about earlier, do you see Stanford in there?
No, sir.
So you're up next. So this
Stanford's
is my,
a fucking library.
This is my, we're about to score, or do we score? We got a penalty.
We're about to score.
We're like 10 seconds delayed from you guys watching. Your second video, go. Let's see it. Do you have it queued up?
Where's my phone
at? We got to find the phone. I can go in.
Device. Dude, iPhones are a scam, by the way.
I got
my
you.
Next phone is
mine will be here Monday.
My next phone's
I'm
Android.
I'm a consumer.
You got the 13?
I'm going due Monday. I got the 12 now. Because you've been killing it on the videos. Are you ready?
Yes.
Please don't start. Come on. All right. 1, 2, 29.7. I think I'm paying for the Duffy tonight, folks. I really do. I'm paying for the Duffy, but you guys better buy me some drinks. You guys all better buy me some drinks. I'm paying for it, okay?
Oh, Mike, I'm going to get you a fucking blowjob
shot. I'm paying for all of it.
Mike,
what did you say? Hold on. You can't. Okay, hold on. See that on the camera.
I'm giving you a little.
You said you're going to get me a blowjob.
No, a blowjob shot.
Oh,
some cream on the top. Yeah.
I've been at so many bachelor parties. I've seen too many strippers for a lifetime. But when I hear the word blowjob, my headphones perked a little bit.
Yeah, man. That's all I have to say.
You're buying me one, or you're going to buy me a shot?
I'm buying you a blowjob shot.
Okay, and then maybe we end up at the strip club tonight.
No.
Okay.
That's a hard no. Mom, if you're watching this, I'm so sorry, but your son's a man.
Hold on.
Deal with it.
Hold on. Ready? Ready? Okay. Mike, when you're editing this, we're going to backtrack. We're going to backtrack 20 seconds.
No strip club.
Okay. I don't know what we're... Okay. All right, I mean, the Trojans are up big, 30-7. We love it, right?
Oh, yeah, we love that. We need that, man.
I mean, we've never lost to Colorado. I mean,
it makes my weeks better when I'm making cold calls when the Trojans win. I feel like I have a better...
But this week, I was... by the way, we got 20 minutes to wrap this shit up, JDan. I'm serious. We got to be... Is your TikTok queued up?
TikTok is ready, man.
All right, ready, folks? 1, 2, 3. TikTok number... 2 of 3 for each of us.
Did I die for my girl? Hell no. My mama? Maybe. But the Cowboys. Ooh, the Cowboys.
Y'all have no defense.
I play defense. I don't care. Oh, God.
You act like we didn't just go to the Super Bowl.
No, that was like 94.
No, it wasn't, bro. It was like 5 years ago.
Okay. Okay. By the way, JDan has been 2 for 2 with TikToks. Why is he chirping the Super Bowl week 2 or 3?
I hate the Cowboys.
I hate the motherfuckers.
Nah, dude, the worst.
The guy is telling his girl that he's going to go to the Super Bowl, right? In week 2.
Yeah, that's just not That's not it.
That ain't it.
Go Raiders, baby. That Raider
ain't
Nation.
It. That ain't it. All right.
All the way. Super Bowl champs 2021.
You want to hear mine? That. We got to go rapid fire here.
Patrick Mahomes sounds like Kermit the Frog.
Rapid fire here. All right, ready. Ready? Rapid fire.
Let's go.
We
next
got
one.
Dan Wilzerian. Shout out the Nut Boys. Dan Wilzerian right now. 1, 2, 3. So you have 2 done? We have 3 each.
Yeah, 2 done.
Here we go. Dan Wilzerian. Hold on. Ready. 1, 2, 3.
I kind of always was pressing it, and I knew that that money spent when I was younger and having those good times when I was younger was worth a lot more than being 70 on a fucking golf course, you know, maybe going on a yacht. Like, I didn't want to be the old rich guy. I want to be the young guy that enjoyed it while I was able to. Because all the shit that I like to do, surfing, you know, banging chicks, partying, traveling, all that stuff is young guy stuff, snowboarding.
So I'll let you comment on the TikTok. Is he right or?
I mean, he's fully right. You know, he talked about a lawsuit for official things. You know, a little bit more wholesome.
No, I know, but his story was you got to live now, not for the future.
Yeah, no, exactly.
And that's what I agree with.
Yeah, I don't want to be 70 with some flabby-ass skin trying to live out my young days.
No.
That's why you grind now, baby. I'm not getting married till I'm 40.
I'm at 33 myself, so I'll see you there. You're a guarantee one of the guys. So I've had some buddies that are getting married, I guess, nowadays. Brian Finley are just getting married left and right.
Finley, baby.
But you will be at my bachelor party, locked in. I've already said that before.
You don't want me at your bachelor party, but
well,
I appreciate that.
I'll tell you one guy that I'm nervous of being there. Jared. He will order a ton of miscellaneous women there.
Yeah. Jared will probably get married, though.
There may be some midgets there.
Oh, my God.
And by the way, he won't even care I'm saying this because I'll ask him, but he's like, Mike...
Midgets, though?
Do you know how many midget strippers I'm going to order to your bachelor party? I'm nervous. He's told me that. He's like, if I got to edit this out, I do. But he said, Mike, when I come on the podcast, I'm going to have a couple midgets just appearing on the show. I believe him. Do you?
I hope I'm in the audience for that.
Oh, my God. All right. Number 3. Go. Cue it up. I got mine queued up, but you've been 2 for 2.
This one's going to be a dud, probably.
It's all good. But your ex-girlfriend worked at TikTok?
Yeah, shout out Sophie.
Shout her out?
Yeah, oh yeah, she's fucking great. Okay. Works at TikTok, she's been grinding. She was there right before the boom. She started December 2018, so... I mean, she's probably a big dog there now. Much respect to her.
Okay, good.
Dude, I can't find this video.
No way. I got a bunch to cover it. So here, you guys ready?
Give me yours.
All right. 1, 2, 3. We'll do it right now. I don't care.
White boy summer every day. My name is Justin. I like big booty Latinas. I feel like a lot of white boys don't want to put down on some thick. A lot of white boys don't want to put down on some thick shit. They're worried about school and economics. Quit being scared. Go get a big booty Latina, sir.
Yes.
Don't worry about nothing else in the world. Get you a big booty Latina.
What would get me a big booty Latina?
You tell me.
I'm already married to one. No, no, see, I did.
Oh, shit.
White boy summer.
Okay. So, this might be the best TikTok.
Yeah.
Oh, you comment.
I mean,
I can't handle the big Latinas.
I mean, well, it all starts with the mind, man. So you manifest it. You know, if you don't think you can handle it, then you can't, you know?
But the video is like the guy was so confident. He was like,
I mean, he said he was married to one. And I bet you his daughter's probably sexy. but all jokes beside, yeah, man. I like the thickies, man.
I know. At least you'll do it for me. I'm like 5'3" below and maybe skinnier, but I can't just can't
handle it. 5'3"?
5'4", 6".
Do you want your kids to be on JV, Mike?
Well, I already was.
Do you want your kids to play?
I already was.
But like, you can.
Yeah, I was the JV king.
You could make up, bro. I won't entertain.
I varsityed in one sport, volleyball. Not my best sport, but I did.
I won't entertain a girl under 5'6", just because of the fact that like I don't want my kids being little shrimp asses. But hey,
I got you.
You
got
to do what you got to do. So hey, if you're 5'6", you big husky. Holla at your boy.
So, oh my God. Okay. I love it. JDan, you delivered two great videos.
Yes.
And I tried to follow you up, but this one, we're bringing back a legend here. And this is one of the guys that was on the Lucky Zubich. You know Lucky?
Oh, dude, Luck's my guy.
He probably doesn't want me to say his last name, but guess what? I love the guy. I'll say it.
His real name is Luke, by the
Luke,
way.
Luke, for the viewers out there.
You're fucking Lucky.
We got a 1 minute TikTok. It's the last TikTok that we're going to talk about. It may be the best one. I want your comment on it, okay? Last one we got, and then we got two more stories, and we're done.
The best way to sign the DM? Yo. The hard eyes. Yo, right? Simple. The hard eyes? Simple.
He's asking, how do you slide in the DM? He said hard eyes. He got into a scrap in San Diego. You're from San Diego, or you live there now?
I live in San Diego now.
This is right there, gas tank district, full scrap. Right there.
Yeah, the gas tank.
You know where that
we're
is?
We're reporting to you live from downtown Westlands. It's Oktoberfest, and we're fucking lit.
What's the best way to slide into the DM, sir?
I don't know. I don't do DMs or none of that stuff. I do old school, just run up on a chick and tell her what's good, ma, you want fuck, pop it, baby girl.
Fuck.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a fugitive, I can't do internet shit.
He hits like a bitch.
Okay. That's the best one to end on. Okay, first off, let's just evaluate it. Hard eyes, I think it works. But he's a bit too aggressive.
No, it's not aggressive at all, dude. Just chicks.
We're talking about how do you slide in the DMs. How do you start in the DMs?
Hard eyes, dude. Hard eyes are like, it depends. Like, if I met the chick, like, a night before, I follow her on Instagram, I'm always like, hey, I'm Jacob. We met at the bar last night. Put my number there, and if she texts me, good. If not, then, hey, you miss more shots than you take.
Exactly.
Right?
Shoot or shoot. All right. TikToks are done. You delivered two good ones. Rapid fire here. Because, folks, we got to go to a Duffy. We got 5 minutes. We have to make the... And by the way, guess what? We will cue the Duffy footage.
Oh, yeah. We're getting some
If
Duffy
these
footage,
viewers maybe. Don't think at the end of the video, full hangover situation, if you watch to the end, you're going to see Duffy, Wild Goose, and whatever happens after.
And that some Raising Cane's, baby.
You might see that. But
can I get a Caniac, please?
If you're watching the video now and you're going to pull a full hangover credit reel, we'll reel the credits. Anyway, rapid fire, waste management. Oh, sorry, trip to Fresno.
Oh my God, dude. What was it, Connor's 23rd or 24th? He's an old motherfucker.
Nick and I have been up there too long. I go every other year.
Dude, I just remember. Dude, that was a fun day.
Is there a photo of me on the sidewalk on a street in Fresno with JDan passed out? Maybe.
Yeah.
If we can find that, we'll find that. And give me that cup right here. Right here. Shut up the post.
They closed down Lux. They closed it down. They have a new spot now. It's called Vixen.
I'm going to give you one comment about my best man, co-best man with my brother, locked in, Connor Fugman.
Fugue is the GOAT, man.
He is.
I love the kid to death.
He really is a GOAT.
I'd go to war for him.
Me too.
Fugue, if you're watching, I'd catch a grenade for you.
I've done it before.
That's all I'm going to say. Love that man to death.
But you act, so I know he's been catching some grief from K. Jordy. We love K. Jordy.
Yeah, I love Jordy too.
All right, I mean, we got to wrap this up. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a Duffy in an hour. It's 1:30. We got to be on the boat at 2:30.
We'll be there at 3.
The video is coming. Like, it's a full hangover situation. Watch the end of the video. I'm not posting it early like I did before. This will be at the very end. And if you don't watch the end, oh, look at the camera. You may be missing out fully. So watch for the end of it. And I don't even know if the viewers are ready for what's going to happen today. I normally say tonight, but today. It's 1:30.
Yeah, if they don't watch the full video, they're a half sender, man.
No, you're half sender. So anyway, wrap it up. I mean, JDan, one of my best friends. Thank you for coming on.
Boy for life. You'll be at my wedding, man.
Me too.
If I get married, I don't know.
And guess what? You will be at my wedding if I get married. So same thing. So like that's how it goes. I will see you there. You'll see me there. But the Trojans are winning today.
That is beautiful.
And let's just bring it back home. What I don't understand is, like, I'm getting emails today, which is, you picked USC over many schools.
Yeah.
And I'm just a fucking ACT grade guy that made it. I worked hard to get into USC. I barely got in. I grinded my ass off.
Yeah.
But I would have never done it any different.
I wouldn't have either. No. You know. I think a lot of guys say, you know, you grind. USC is a institution for really talented individuals. So,
and if you're watching, you probably can't get in, right? You agree?
No,
probably not.
You work hard. Hey, my advice to people is just to do grad school there.
I'm sorry, but flash the acceptance rate behind us. It's 12. It's like, I think it's 8%.
Yeah, just do grad school.
8 to 10%. Anyway,
go to Fresno State, do grad school.
All right, one more story, and then we're gonna. Actually, we have some booze to drink. We got 5 minutes. Actually.
Mine's full, man. I got to piss so bad.
Oh, man. All right. One more thing. You are a NBA legend, a Super Bowl legend, and a UFC legend. Give us your picks.
2021 NBA, realistically, Nets, Dream, Warriors.
I'm a Lakers. Big Warriors fan. Laker Nation.
Fuck the Lakers. I hate Russell Westbrook. Lakers suck.
Okay.
NFL, I got Raiders, baby.
So we play on Monday, Charger.
I know. I'm excited for that game, and we're gonna blow you guys out. Dude, the thing is, it's literally a home game.
Hold on. Do you want to make a bet on the Mic'd Up podcast?
Yeah, I'll make a bet, dude.
What's the bet?
You have to record yourself doing 100 push-ups.
Simple. It'll take an hour. I'm saying this. If Chargers,
all right. I want to hear your bet.
If Chargers win. You have to, I don't know, the loser of the Monday Night Football game buys the Duffy for 2 hours. It'll be $250. Are you that confident? If not, are you that confident?
Yeah, let's fucking do it.
The loser of Monday Night Football buys the future Duffy for 2 hours.
All right, the Duffy today?
No, in the future. And one clause, you provide the girls.
Shake on it, dude.
Monday Night Football. You got a bet right
Shake
here.
On it, bro. I'm not.
Monday Night Football, Chargers, Raiders. I'm a big Charger guy, and there's no Charger fans in this world anymore. Raiders. All right. Let's go, Duffy, Raiders, baby. Newport send. The bet is for $250, and you're that confident.
Yep.
Okay.
There you go.
It's signed, sealed, delivered, and it's on YouTube.
And
so.
you're not worried.
Oh, dude, I have no worries in the world, dude.
But the Trojans are firing up.
Like, do babies let's shit their these. Pants? Let's are the Raiders going to win on Sunday? Yeah.
Chug these real quick.
Oh, fuck. That shit was cold as hell. God
and
damn.
Guess what, folks? This shit is done. But before we go, we got to shout out the Post. How was it being here at the Post? My favorite bar.
I mean, it's a great
place.
It goes
the Post, Nino, for me.
It's hard, man. Emotional attachment to the Nino, but the Post is a great facility.
This is my bar, dude.
Thank you for hosting us.
Thank you. Look in the camera. Say thank you.
Yeah, no, seriously. It's been nothing but a pleasure. Love that burrito that I had this morning.
And guess what? The post logo will be on the bottom right of the video at all times on YouTube.
That's awesome.
We're shouting out the Post. The service was unreal.
It was unreal.
Raphael.
Shout out Raphael, Will, Billy, everybody involved.
Raphael's my middle name.
Is it? No way.
Yeah, it is, dude.
I don't believe you.
My name is Jacob Raphael Daniel.
I think you... Hey, hold on one second. Before we close this out, Trojans up 30-14. I'm buying the Duffy.
You!
So that. You guys do not owe anything. I'm buying it. I'm shouldering it. I actually mean that. I'm shouldering the Duffy. Don't worry about it. But buy me some drinks. That's all I ask. Thank you for coming to my show. Can we hear the crowd yell a little bit? And then before we... I'm going to put the crowd on blast here. This will be edited. 1, 2, 3. How was the crowd? Let's hear it. Let's go. All right, man. Fight on. Jacob, thanks for coming on.
Dude, thanks you for having me. It's been a fucking pleasure, man.
And we'll see you guys later. 1, 2, 3. We're done. Hold on. People are getting eager if you've watched this far.
Cue the send video.
We're not leaving yet.
Dude, I'm gonna shit myself.
Okay. We got some viewers, Mike, that wouldn't appreciate to hear that. So you gotta
Mike, you gotta, I'm literally gonna shit.
Okay. Cue the send video.
No, like later.
He's just fucking around. Alright, folks.
Cue the send.
Once we finish these, cue the ending, and thank you for watching Mic'd Up. JDan. We're gonna finish.
Dude, this is mine. This is mine.
Alright. Fight on. We love the Trojans. And what you are. You have to.
Oh, fuck.
Folks, let's take one sip and we'll end this. I mean, by the way, you've seen us cue a bottle of champagne in 10 minutes.
Dude, it was less than that.
Wasn't less than that.
Goddamn.
Are you feeling it?
Oh, I feel great. Dude, I'm about to do backflips.
All right. Cheers. And once we take one sip, we're gonna end the video. Cue the send video. And if you're watching, enjoy. And do you even want to know what's on the reel in the future that's gonna be cued?
We'll just find out, man.
Yeah. All right. Thank you for watching Mic'd Up Podcast. When we cheers and we drink, it's done. Let's go.
Hey. Hi, Mom. I love you.
I love you, Mom. She left about 30 minutes ago. Cheers, brother.
Let's
Thanks
do
for
it.
Coming on.
Thank you, brother.
Thanks for coming on, big dog. Hey, fight on. Let's go. Cue it. Is this guy? Let's go. All right,
like the
baby. All right.
Let me see a sender. Come on.
Like new box?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
There's a man right there.
The Trojans win. We all win. Yo, you got a girl tonight, Hyder. Tonight, we're going to Wild Goose, and This is my bucket now. That's all I gotta say. We'll see you in a minute. We'll see you in a minute, guys. Out.
My seat! Like the podcast. Like the podcast. 645. Fantastic. Look at it. You can't really beat it.
We're live. Beautiful.
It's a lot here. Just the boys on the boat.
And you know what? The Trojans won. What a great podcast. We left the GoPro, but we're dealing with iPhones. You guys just stay tuned. We're going to pick up the GoPro, and tonight, wait till you see the footage, right? Cheers. We're going out big. Cheers. Let's go. Stay tuned. It ain't done yet. If you think it's done, it ain't done yet. We'll see you guys later.
It ain't done, baby.
See ya.
Tuning in to the Mic'd Up Podcast. Be sure to tune in again for the next episode on Apple Music, Spotify, or YouTube. See you next time.
Bye-bye.